Next, we are going to take up liquid state. Intramolecular forces of attraction are stronger in liquid state than in gaseous state because that the intramolecular space is less. So molecules in liquids are so close that there is very little empty space, which is called intramolecular space between them under normal conditions. And that is the reason that liquids are denser than gases. They have more density than gases. Less volume as compared to the gases. Molecules of liquids are held together by attractive forces of attraction. This force of attraction is more than the gaseous state but less than the solid state. Liquids have definite volume, that is fixed volume. If you have taken 100 ml of water, you put in different containers, it will remain 100 ml only. Why the volume remains constant? Because molecules do not separate from each other and they have appreciable force of attraction. However, molecules of liquid can move past one another freely. Therefore, liquids can flow and can be poured and can also assume the shape of the container in which they are stored. And that is why the shape of liquid is not fixed. Next topic we are taking is vapor pressure. If we have an empty container and it is partially filled with a liquid, a portion of liquid evaporates to fill the remaining volume of the container with the vapors. And you know that gas molecules collide with each other. And similarly, these vapor molecules are also colliding with each other. And the collision of these gas molecules among themselves and with the walls of the container exert pressure. This pressure is called vapor pressure. Initially, the liquid evaporates and pressure exerted by vapors on the walls of the container, that is vapor pressure, increases. After some time, it becomes constant. An equilibrium is established between liquid phase and vapor phase. What is meant by equilibrium? That is the rate of changing liquid into vapors and vapors into liquid becomes equal. And this is called equilibrium. And the vapor pressure exerted by vapors at this stage is called equilibrium vapor pressure. It is also called saturated vapor pressure. Since the process of vaporization is a temperature dependent, means higher the temperature, more vaporization will take place. That is the reason that rain comes in summers. Why in summers? Because water gets evaporated and it forms clouds. And on condensation, rain comes. So, when the temperature is high, vaporization is faster. The temperature must be mentioned while reporting the vapor pressure of the liquid, because vapor pressure of liquid will be at particular temperature. And if we increase the temperature, vapor pressure will increase. If we decrease the temperature, vapor pressure will decrease. When a liquid is heated in an open vessel, the liquid vaporizes from the surface. At the temperature at which vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equal to external pressure or atmospheric pressure, vaporization can occur throughout the bulk of the liquid and vapors expand freely into surroundings. This is called boiling. This condition of free vaporization throughout the liquid is called boiling. The temperature at which vapor pressure of liquid becomes equal to atmospheric pressure or external pressure is called boiling temperature or boiling pressure, boiling point at that pressure. Vapor pressure of some common liquids at various temperatures is given in the coming figure. At one atmospheric pressure, boiling temperature is called normal boiling point. And these days we are taking pressure in bar. And if we take pressure at 1 bar, then the boiling point is called standard boiling point of the liquid. Since 1 bar and 1 atmosphere are not equal, therefore normal boiling point and standard boiling point will not be equal. Standard boiling point of the liquid is slightly lower than that of normal boiling point because one pressure is slightly more than 1 atmospheric pressure. 1 bar is equal to 1.01 atmosphere. The normal boiling point of water is 100 degree centigrade, that is 373 Kelvin. Standard boiling point is 99.6 degree centigrade. Now this graph shows the vapor pressure versus temperature of various liquids. Diethyl ether, which is highly volatile, its boiling point is 308 Kelvin. And at 308 Kelvin, its vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. Carbon tetrachloride vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure at 349.7 Kelvin, and for ethyl alcohol at 351.3 Kelvin, ethyl alcohol will start boiling, and this is the boiling point where vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. Water has got highest boiling point among these, because at 373 Kelvin the vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. This graph also shows that the force of attraction between water molecule is maximum, that is why its boiling point is highest. Diethyl ether has minimum intramolecular force of attraction, that is why its boiling point is low. So boiling point is also related with intramolecular force of attraction. Also, if the liquid has high vapor pressure, it will have low boiling point. And if liquid has low vapor pressure, it will have high boiling point. At higher altitudes, atmospheric pressure is low. Therefore, liquids at higher altitudes boil at lower temperature in comparison to at sea level. Now, if I ask you a question that a hill station water will boil at 100, below 100 or above 100, the correct answer is water will boil below 100. Why it will boil below 100 degrees centigrade? The reason is atmospheric pressure at higher altitude is less. So at lower temperature, the vapor pressure of water will become equal to atmospheric pressure. That is, it will boil at lower temperature than 100 degrees centigrade. And that is why vegetable does not get cooked properly, particularly pulses, at hill station. Now, since water boils at low temperature on hills, therefore the people are advised to use pressure cooker so that they can cook the food faster and saving energy, and it can be cooked properly. In hospitals, surgical instruments are sterilized in autoclaves in which boiling point of water is increased by increasing the pressure above the atmospheric pressure by using the weight covering the vent. That is, we can increase the boiling point of water above 100 degrees centigrade. How? By increasing the pressure. Means, if we increase the pressure, boiling point of water will be increased. For example, in pressure cooker, the water boils at higher temperature because the steam form exerts pressure on the liquid water and increases its boiling point. And secondly, latent heat of steam is also used in cooking. That is the reason that the pressure cooker is used for cooking vegetables, pulses, faster. So the water which has got boiling point higher than 100 degrees centigrade, which can be obtained at higher pressure, is also called superheated water. Next property of liquids we will take up is surface tension. Now, what is surface tension? It is well known fact that liquids acquire the shape of the container, that is, they do not have fixed shape. Now, you must have observed the drops of liquid. What do you find? You find the small drops of liquids are spherical in shape. They do not spread on the surface, rather form spherical shape. Why do particles of soil at the bottom of river remain suspended, but they stick together when taken out? And why does a liquid rise or fall in a thin capillary as soon as capillary touches the surface of the liquid? Now, answer to all these questions is, it is due to surface tension. And surface tension is characteristic property of the liquid. A molecule in the bulk experiences equal intramolecular forces from all sides. Now, observe this diagram. Inside, the molecule has equal force of attraction from all the directions. Whereas, observe the molecule in the surface. When you observe the surface molecule, it is attracted by the molecules in the bulk, and there are no molecules above the surface. Therefore, it is not attracted from the top. Therefore, there is a strain on the surface molecules. That is, they are stretched downward or attracted downwards, and they acquire a convex shape or concave shape, which is due to surface tension. But for molecules on the surface of the liquid, net attractive force is towards the interior of the liquid due to the molecules below it. Since there are not molecules above it, that is why it feels surface tension. Now, liquid tends to minimize their surface area. These molecules on the surface experience a net downward force and have more energy than the molecules in the bulk, which do not experience any net force. Therefore, liquids tend to have minimum number of molecules at their surface. And if the surface is increased by pulling a molecule from the bulk, attractive forces will have to be overcome. This will require expenditure of energy. The energy required to increase the surface area of the liquid by unit is by unity or unit is defined as surface energy. And the units of surface energy or dimensions of surface energy are joules per meter square. So surface tension is defined as the force acting per unit length perpendicular to the line drawn on the surface of the liquid. It is denoted by gamma. It has dimension kilogram second minus 2. And in SI unit, it is expressed as Newton per meter square. The lowest energy state of the liquid will be when the surface area is minimum. Spherical shape satisfies this condition. That is, spherical shape has got minimum surface area, and that is the reason that mercury drops are spherical in shape due to surface tension. And that is the reason that sharp glass edges are heated for making them smooth. On heating, the glass melts and the surface of the liquid tends to take the rounded shape at the edges, which makes the edges smooth. This is called fire polishing of the glass. Liquid tends to rise or fall in the capillary because of surface tension. Liquids wet the things because they spread across the surface as a thin film. There is another reason why water sticks to the glass, because adhesive forces between the water and glass are more than the cohesive forces, the force of attraction between water molecules. Mercury does not stick to the glass because here cohesive forces between mercury atoms are more than adhesive forces between glass and mercury atoms. Moist soil grains are pulled together because surface area of the thin film of water is reduced. It is surface tension which gives stretching property to the surface of the liquid. On flat surface, droplets are slightly flattened by the effect of gravity. But in the gravity-free environments, drops are perfectly spherical. The magnitude of surface tension of liquid depends upon attractive forces between the molecules. For example, in mercury, surface tension is higher than water because interatomic force of attraction in mercury are much higher than intermolecular force of attraction in water. When the attractive forces are large, the surface tension is large. Now, increase in temperature increases the kinetic energy of the molecule and effectiveness of intermolecular force of attraction decreases. So surface tension decreases as the temperature is raised, and if temperature is lowered, then surface tension will increase. Surface tension increases with increase in pressure, because when we increase pressure, intermolecular force of attraction will increase, and that is the reason that surface tension will increase. Next topic we are going to take up, viscosity. In simple words, viscosity is defined as resistance to the flow of the liquid. That is, it is the like friction which does not allow the flow of the liquids. It is one of the characteristic properties of the liquid. Viscosity is measure of the resistance to the flow which arises due to internal friction between the layers of the fluid or liquid as they slip past one another when liquid flows. Strong intermolecular force of attraction between the molecules will hold them together and resist the movement of layers over each other. Greater the viscosity, more slowly the liquid flows. For example, honey moves very slowly as compared to water. Concentrated sulfuric acid is oily liquid or viscous liquid. Its viscosity is more, so it will flow very slowly. Hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces of attraction are strong enough to cause high viscosity. Glass is an extremely viscous liquid. It is also called supercooled liquid. It is so viscous that many of its properties resemble with solid, but it is called pseudo solid. However, the property of flow of glass can be experienced by measuring the thickness of window panes of old building, we find that the density of window glass panes or window panes is more at the bottom and less at the top, which shows that the glass can flow like liquids. These become thicker at the bottom than the top due to the flow of glass, and that is why the glass is called supercooled liquid. Viscosity of liquid decreases as the temperature rises. Why it decreases? Because intermolecular force of attraction decreases and kinetic energy of molecule increases, and which can overcome the intermolecular force of attraction, and the liquid can move very easily. And liquid can move easily only when viscosity decreases. Viscosity increases with increase in pressure. Why? Because when we increase the pressure, intermolecular force of attraction increases. Now, if intermolecular force of attraction is more, it will offer more resistance to the flow of liquid, and liquid will be more viscous and it won't be able to move easily. So viscosity decreases with the increase in temperature and increases with the increase in pressure. That completes liquid state.